Gen X,
Gen Y,
Gen Z,
Millennials,
Strawberry Generation, and Snowflake Generation. Welcome to your podcast, Next Door.
Next Door. Next Door. Next Door. Next Door.
Grab yourself a cup of tea
and join us on Tea Talk.
Presenting the hosts of Tea Talk,
Khai and Tiara.
Hey guys, welcome back to the podcast, which is
Tea Talk.
Wow. This is episode 8 of our podcast. Can you believe that? 8 episodes already.
I know. I think a part of me feels like we should have had more, but we took a break during Ramadan, so it's okay.
It could probably be like 12 episodes already if we were to be still continuing our podcast over Ramadan, right?
True that.
It could be 12 or 13 or 14 or 15.
That's true.
It could be 20 if we were
very
hardworking.
Yeah.
But we're not.
Yeah. Definitely not.
Yeah, we are not. Wow, what a week it has been.
Yes, definitely. So many things. Oh yeah, there's just a lot of things happening.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
But okay, I just want to bring something new to the table. Okay, because all this while, we just pick one topic and then we talk and rant and just talk about it nonstop, right? For like 30 minutes all the way to possibly beyond half an hour.
Yeah.
So I want to include something new because you see, every week there are a lot of new interesting things happen. And not everyone reads the news. Okay. So I'm guessing listeners who listen to our podcast, people who listen to our podcast, if they were to miss the week's long news, at least we can keep them up to speed.
That's true.
Ah.
It's kind of like a flash briefing. Ooh,
flash briefing. I always have that on my Alexa.
Yeah.
Because every month.
Oh.
Okay, it didn't trigger.
Thank God.
Yeah, okay. Okay, we shall not say that name, okay? Yeah. That
he who shall not, she who shall not be named.
Yeah, because every time we say that name, that Sa
Alexa.
Yeah, the Alexa, right? Okay, it will get triggered and then it will start to receive commands.
Yeah, and then she's like, I don't understand.
Yeah.
Please and repeat.
It doesn't help that we just got a new one, right?
Oh, yeah. At
the desktop, and it's like 1.5 arms reach from where I'm seated.
Yeah, but I'm surprised that she didn't.
Yeah, probably a bit pekat already because
but
every time hear my
it.
Voice,
huh? We just bought it.
I don't know. Probably today she's sick of my voice. I don't know.
Or maybe she's just having a moment. Anyway.
Yeah. Okay. So there are two very, very super big topics that happened for the past week, but this is not the thing that we want to talk about today. Okay, episode 8 is not about these two big topics. Episode 8 is actually about something which is bigger than these two topics. I don't know if they are going to be bigger though. Okay, it's as big. It's as big, okay? We'll just leave it as that. It is as big. But the two big topics of the week. Number one is the government has been dissolved.
Jing, jing, jing. We are all aimless people just listening to rules and regulations that we have grown up with.
Is it anarchy already? No lah. Cannot be anarchy.
Wow, yeah, because, so dramatic.
Yeah, because the police is still around.
That's true.
And because of this, is it dissolvement? Is that the right word? Because of this process, all right? General elections has been called and general elections fever is on.
Ooh.
Oh my God. Wait, I want to press a button, but I cannot see what button is which because it's just too dark. Okay, let's try this. Hey, that's our intro. Wait, is that the right vibe that we want to give? General elections is on. I guess it's okay, lah.
Yeah, but then again, guys, you have to understand that literally these buttons, follow Karun on Instagram and you'll be able to see. Karun, the buttons are just very colorful and all you want to do is just press on them. So that's why we just randomly press. But anyway, it can be mean an applause because, you know, it's finally, I don't know, I'm just saying it may be time for
a fresh
start.
Outlook on things.
So it may be like a yay thing.
Yeah. It depends on a lot of factors.
Yeah.
But because both of us are not politically affiliated, All we can say is choose wisely, or rather vote wisely.
Mm-hmm.
Right? I think that's the only thing we can advise. Nothing more. Because as much as we want to, say more things, I don't think we are equipped. That's number one. Number two, we don't want this platform to be a political platform.
Yeah, I just don't want the president to hate me.
Okay.
Well, you know, like, it's,
yeah, okay, there. There's a lot of other people who loves you. Okay. So it's okay if one human being just hates you. It's okay.
No, I don't want
to. I still love you. Right? Your mom still loves you.
I just don't
want. Your mother-in-law still loves you.
I just don't want like a Facebook post.
Oh, touchy.
That's what I'm saying, but. Yeah.
Yeah. You have to remind me to always be doing all these buttons because, you know, all this while, I've only been pressing like one button. Okay? I need to press more. Okay, that's how...
Just don't press my buttons.
Oh, okay. Shall not. I noted.
Where's the...
Noted with thanks. Huh?
Got the scary...
Okay, noted with thanks. Okay, I won't press your buttons. Yeah, I won't. So anyways, that is the biggest topic of the entire week. And yes, again, general elections fever is on, right? So for the next few weeks, we will see a lot of campaigning happening. And it all boils down to the 10th of July, 2020, because it's...
Election Day.
Ooh.
Right?
Yes.
It's like the voting day, huh? Polling day.
Sorry. Yeah, polling day, elections day, voting day. It's the same, lah.
You know what's interesting? What? Like, when everyone heard about the news of GE, right? I think the hilarious memes that came about was about the guy who always will announce. You know, that guy who's like, from section, don't know what, of the constituency, I don't know how many votes I declare this party, and then he always says it in the most like,
his face is always, a very poker face.
Yes, and he just comes on, comes on the screen and he just like, on the section, I think
he's just trying to be as neutral as possible, so he cannot announce it and then smile at the same time.
Like,
he cannot.
Oh my God, guys. He's like,
but imagine if that was the case, you get someone who's like, happy person, very jumpy, maybe get, who's the alien lady? Michelle Chong.
Oh my god, I love her video.
They should totally get her to do all the announcements.
The premium land, right?
Yeah, the premium land. Oh, shout out to Michelle Chong. You have a very fantastic channel.
I love it. I look forward every week to watch her premium SES. Premium land SES talk show.
Yeah.
Talk show.
So if any government bodies who's listening to this podcast, and please consider our suggestion very, very strongly. Okay, get Michelle Chong, right?
Yeah, Michelle Chong.
Michelle Chong on that polling result platform. Okay, get her there. Let her do the announcement.
I think we will all pay attention.
Oh my God. I would make it, probably make the entire result announcement ratings super, super high.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, do consider this very, very strongly. Please.
Michelle Chong, I love you.
Okay, that is topic number one. Big one. Topic number two.
Now all you do is just press that button, right?
I know. Wait. Or is it this one better?
No.
Yes. Spa-like, huh? It's like you just came out from a very long bath.
Yeah.
Okay? So imagine. Okay, everyone close your eyes. Close your eyes. You also, close your eyes.
Okay, sorry.
Okay, close your eyes. Imagine you have, your bathtub, candlelight, aromatic candle, right? And you just soak your feet in that warm water, just soaking it in, and living at that moment, all right? And then you step out of the bath. Yes, that's how you should be feeling.
Mm.
Okay? As much as I hate to mention this, because, topic number two will be Liverpool winning the English Premier League.
Yeah, congratulations to all Liverpool fans.
Congrats, Liverpool, and the fans who have been waiting. Okay, I see a lot of 30 years.
Is it 30 years? I cannot believe it.
Okay, actually...
It's fake, right?
Actually, it is lah. Because EPL, the trophy, the premiership, right?
The trophy,
The trophy, yeah. The championship trophy.
Isn't it trophy?
Trophy. Okay, like trophy. Wait, trophy. Have I always been saying trophy?
You're weird.
Okay, trophy. Okay, the mouth need to be a bit narrower.
Oh.
True.
Makhrajnya...
trophy.
Must make an O with your lips. Yeah. Too light.
Trophy. Trophy.
Too trophy. Too salah.
Oh, salah, huh? Okay, trophy. Did I say trophy again? Trophy. Okay, trophy. The EPL trophy started back in 1992.
Hey, that's the year I was born.
You were. So it's only been 27 years. 28 years, I'm sorry.
I like Karun has, the whole day Karun seems to think that I'm 27.
Yeah, I don't know why.
I also don't know why. Beardo. Well,
yeah. I should have known better, right?
Yeah, you were
28, 27.
Yeah.
I think I know why. For me.
Huh? I think I know why. You're confused with your age. Because you are 37.
Yeah, so I only subtract 10 from mine.
But we are 9 years apart.
Which I should have been subtracting 9 instead. Weird. So anyways, Liverpool has won the English Premier League. Woohoo!
Wow.
Hey, but, there was this TV presenter. I think she was on one of the Malaysian networks. If I'm not wrong, I could be wrong. So she was saying, obviously she's a Liverpool fan lah. So she was saying, hey, you know what, guys, Liverpool, you know, they call it what you want, call them the COVID champion and everything. But hey, look, they won after taking a 3 months break. Okay? No one in history has gone on a 3 months break, come back and played to win. Played 2 matches and then they win. No one, you know, so she was saying this like it's a matter of fact.
But isn't it accumulative from before COVID?
Okay, the thing is...
Okay, guys, sorry, here, I don't understand anything about EPL, so please forgive me.
Before the COVID break, Liverpool actually needed one more win to win the English Premier League.
Okay.
Okay. So the way she said it, she said it, it's like, wow, Liverpool, you know, have to go through so much after the COVID period, you know, like have to go through sweat and tears and blood, and then they win. I mean, come on, lah. It's just one more win.
Okay, I get it. I get it why it's like a bit.
Yeah.
Like very extra. Okay, I get it. Like, congratulations, but...
Yeah. Yeah, but as a Manchester United fan, I really, really honestly think that Liverpool has been superb this season. They
are coming
like,
from you,
wow.
Oh my God, wow.
Yeah, but really, you really have to give it to them. They've been performing like, wow. It's something which I believe would go beyond winning the English Premier League. I don't think they... they can just stop there because the quality of the players, of how they are performing, they can reach heights which they have not reached so far.
I mean, coming from me, who's like, I don't really watch EPL at all. I just like to grab some popcorn, read stuff on Twitter and see what people have to say. It seems like Liverpool has gotten their shit together.
Yeah.
Like in terms of like their strat and as well as their players that they purchase.
Yeah, they purchase.
Yeah, purchase. Mm. I still find it so weird to say I purchase this player, this player is on loan. Like, oh my god. Like human beings, people. But anyway,
no, it's not a slave trade.
Yeah,
it's
I know. It's just the way they say it's like, yeah. I buy this for $1.1 million. Mm.
They could term it better, I guess. Yeah. Right.
But I mean, again, it's not saying that.
Yeah, there's no trafficking involved here.
Yeah,
okay.
It's just, the way they say it's like, I find it weird, but
you'll get there. You'll get to it. It's okay.
But anyway, I must say that from all of the tweets that I've read over the last year-ish or a couple of months since EPL started, I think I would say that, I mean, I know that you're a Manchester United fan, but I would have to say that I think Manchester United needs a lot of work.
Right now? Yeah. Right now.
What do you think?
Okay.
I mean, previously they need a lot of work, right? Like so many changes in like managers,
yeah,
and then like the players are just injured, cannot, like, basically Manchester United hasn't been performing, I mean, you have to admit it, because guys, you have to understand, I'm that at those 3 a.m., 4 a.m. morning games that I am fast asleep, I sometimes hear my beloved husband go, puro. And then I'm just
a lot of frustrations.
Like, it's nighttime.
Yeah, calm down.
Yeah. Which?
Then I just give you the look.
Yeah.
Right. The don't disturb me.
Yeah.
Go back to sleep.
And then there's, interesting story. Like, after we got married, there was some EPL matches, and then Karun was like, okay, hun, I'm going to wake up at 3:45, 4 o'clock to watch soccer. Then I'm like, oh, okay. So sleep. And then suddenly I like woke up. I kind of like, what do you call that? Macam tersada in English. Like I was
awoken.
Yeah,
abruptly.
I just suddenly woke up. Like, I went tersada. And then I was like wondering, why is this guy like wake up so early? And then I checked my phone, it was like 2:45. And then this got me, I was like, I forgot. And then I was like, Han, why are you awake? Go and sleep. Then he was like, okay. So I just, and then I fell asleep. And then in the morning I asked him, like, oh my god, so do you wake up for your match?
No, I woke up and I got angry with you.
Oh, is it?
Because, okay, first you asked me to go and sleep.
And no, the thing
and
is,
and secondly, the most stupidest thing is I went to listen to you.
Yeah, he slept.
I was like, okay. I'll listen to, I don't know why.
Yeah, I also don't know. Then suddenly he scolded me. I was like, but you had the choice.
Yeah, I know. Until now, I was just thinking back and then, wait, I had the choice whether I need to wake up and watch soccer or not to listen to my wife.
But anyway, listen to me.
But then I put everything aside and I just decided to listen to you.
Is it like a newlywed thing?
I don't know. And it didn't cross me that, okay, I can just ignore you. You know? I can do that. I have that ability.
I think this is one of the most iconic stories that we have. Like when we got married.
I'm rebellious by nature. And I don't know why, just for that stupid moment, I was just, okay, I'll listen to you.
Okay. In the morning, I'm like, oh.
Yeah, I got so much regrets after that.
Do you even win?
Man, you won. I think big win. And I couldn't watch it firsthand just because I had to listen to you. No, not I had to listen. I listened to you.
And then he scolded me. And I'm like, what did I do? Yeah, you asked me to sleep. Then you go and listen. Yeah.
I don't want to listen to this thing anymore.
So ever since then, when he wants to watch soccer, like right before we sleep, he'll be like, Han, I'm going to wake up at 2:45 to watch soccer. Don't make me sleep. Then I'm like, oh, okay.
All right. So again, Liverpool fans and Liverpool team, a big congratulations to all of you for winning 2019-2020 season in a very, very high. Hey, wait, they were breaking up. They were breaking records, you know. Mm. I think they've got one of the highest EPL records, like 100 points or something.
Wow. Yeah.
And that's very, very hard to achieve.
Very good. Very good. Well done.
Okay, Liverpool, continue the good fight. We'll see you next season. Okay, we also decided for this episode, we want to give some shout outs to our friends who has businesses of their own. So for this episode, we are going to do two advertisements. All right, we're going to just do it. And yeah, you'll listen to it in about now.
The only kind of bakes to make your day today,
tomorrow and forever.
Bakes by Petit Publishers.
Head on over to thetcollective.com/Petit Publishers
or WhatsApp 8815-6790.
All right, welcome back from that break, advertisement break. This will be one of many, many, many advertisements that we're going to do for our future episodes. All right, just for this episode, we're going to feature two advertisements. Ooh, interesting. Yeah. So if you guys want us to do a shout out advertisement, something like what you just heard, so all you need to do is just email
tiaradusqie.official@gmail.com.
Right. Where you can also find this email address is on Spotify's... I keep saying Spotify. Another place where you can find the email address is in Spotify's description box. Okay? Just look under this episode, the description. You can find tiaradusqie.official@gmail.com. Okay, I'm just confusing you all. One more time, Tiara.
It's tiaradusqie.official@gmail.com.
Yeah, whatever she said.
Yeah.
Not me, yeah? Don't listen to me. Okay, so moving on to today's topic. Wow. It's going to be like the half an hour mark and then we talk about today's topic. How good are we? So anyways, yes, we are going to talk about post-circuit breaker phase two.
Wow, congratulations, wow, guys. We made it. We are in phase two. But it definitely does not mean that we are out of the woods.
Yeah, the
out
woods
of
yet.
We are not in the clear. But yeah, this is, as we are recording this, this will be the second weekend of phase two.
Yeah, this is the Saturday, yeah? The 15th day ever since Phase 2 started.
No lah. Huh? Phase 2 started last week only, what? Last Friday.
Was it?
Yes.
Oh yeah, sorry.
Yeah, so it's like 1 week.
Probably 8 days. 8 days since 19th of June 2020. Okay, actually, on Friday, last Friday, we are really out and about. Mm. Okay, we were at Changi Airport and it wasn't so bad, right? We still didn't see a lot of crowded places when we went out. I mean, from the point when we step out of our house all the way to Changi Airport, we didn't see a lot of people gathering and crowding at certain points or at certain places. On Saturday, we also went out. We actually did an entire vlog. If you haven't catched that vlog, do go to Khai and Tiara channel on YouTube. Just check it out. This is like the first vlog of, not 2020, right?
No, I think it's after, yeah. It's
post-CB.
Post-CB,
right? And we haven't been vlogging for a while. So this vlog, while doing all this vlog, we were already... seeing a lot of crowds gathering, and there's a lot of people who, I don't know, to me, when I see people crowding, right, or going to certain shops, queuing to go into certain shops, a part of me is just telling me that people are just being normal again.
Yeah.
You know, things are getting back to normal. There are, however, okay, and then another part of me is saying that I should be paranoid, you know, because the cases are still there. It hasn't dissipated away. The government even said that they are going to do tests from 1st of July. Anyone with acute respiratory condition, they are supposed to be tested for COVID-19. And Tiara and I, we were hoping that all of these tests could happen during the circuit breaker period.
Yeah, because that was what Korea did, like South Korea did. That's why they had like, unfortunately now they have like new clusters lah. But at the time when they were doing, you know, when their cases were still quite high, I think they were actively testing every single person.
Yeah.
So once they did, then they isolate. That's why suddenly like, yeah, they really did flatten the curve. But yeah, we have the option now if let's say, I mean, inshallah, we won't get sick, inshallah. But if we do for some reason, like for example, if we come in with a flu or something, we will automatically have to get the COVID-19 test done.
Yeah. And I also feel that, you know, because the government says that right now, from 1st of July, there has to be compulsory testing. It's also telling me that COVID-19 is still active out there.
Yeah, for sure.
You know, and we shouldn't be complacent whereby we can just go on our gallivanting ways. You know, remember how we were before circuit breaker started? We were like free-spirited, going to places, meeting people and not really caring about self-hygiene.
Oh, yeah.
Right? And I really hope that phase two, all of these things that we were practicing pre-circuit breaker will not happen again. At the same time, even today when we went out, a part of me still feels that I'm a little bit worried, you know, because there's a lot of times where we are in close contact with people, especially when we are in public transport.
Okay, so backstory, today we actually went out. So, I mean, I know that we are kind of like pot calling the kettle black kind of thing, but...
We are?
Well, I mean, in a sense, where we're telling people to be careful.
My kettle is white.
Okay. We're telling people to be careful, but at the same time, we are also like heading out and stuff. And I don't think that it's wrong to go out, but I think that we still really need to be careful. Don't just take for granted that we can go out. So, like, just make sure... I think for me today, I was quite overwhelmed actually. That's why I got tired at the end of like our day out, because I was just, guys, today the crowd was like
crazy.
It was mad. Like it literally like what Kairun said, like as though COVID is like disappeared like that.
Yeah, it
really feels like that. Like, yeah, you just have to like check in and check out using safe entry and then take temperature and all that. But the crowds were still there. And for a brief moment I was like, oh my god, can we just like get out, can we go home, because I don't feel confident. Everyone is wearing masks and all that, but you really really will never know. And I'm not to be negative, but I'm not surprised if there will be a spike in community cases in the next couple of weeks, or maybe in the next 2 weeks, because it takes 2 weeks for the incubation period, right?
Yeah, I think it's also important on how you see or how you view things. Like for the both of us, for these two weekends, last weekend and this weekend, our practice has always been, if there's a crowd, we won't go near it.
Yeah, but today was just, everyone was crowding.
Yeah, today everywhere is crowded.
Like we couldn't even avoid, guys. Like it was just like, I can only take 2 steps to avoid people. Like if you go... But I must say, okay, you know how you mentioned like there are queues to go in places? Actually, that's actually not a bad reason, not a bad thing in a sense whereby because the particular store is limiting the amount of human beings inside
quota.
The store. So that's why you have to queue outside before you can get in, because it's a one in, one out kind of thing.
Mm.
So I think in a way that's good, but it's bad also because people are like queuing up outside. So... It's a, I don't know, I feel like it's a double-edged sword in a way. I appreciate that some stores actually limit the quota and they were very strict about it. So I think we had
Zara was good.
Yeah, Zara was great. Zara was like, okay, you wait first, like after you checked in, and then when two people go in, then they were let two in. So in, like, for example, Zara, right, you can actually do legit social distancing. You don't have to stand very close to people because there's ample space for you to be apart from people.
That's right.
But like, oh my God, I think the worst place was Orchard MRT station.
Oh my God. Yeah. The entry to Ion, right?
Yeah.
Oh,
so God. When we went there, we took a bus down and we arrived like around 12-ish. So it was pretty similar for us. We just like strolled in and then safe entry and then checked in and then we just went about our way. But when we wanted to check out, geez Louise, man, like the line was just crawling from you know, the entrance of the Orchard MRT exit that's like exits towards Ion. It was from there and the line was snaking all the way until like what, UOB or Citibank or something.
Yeah. Almost Wisma area.
Yeah, almost Wisma area, yeah. Correct. And I think that's, I don't know whether it's because black people are like scanning and putting their IC. It could be that's causing the congestion. But oh my God, like the crowd was, I didn't tell you, but I was actually very scared. That's why I told you, I was like, hey, let's go up and out.
That's why we were walking so fast, you know, just to get out of that.
Like everyone was kind of just strolling and like, I was just like, oh, I have no time for this. I'm just going to zoom past you and like leave. But actually, we should have, you know what we should have used? We should have used that spaceout.gov website that actually showcases how crowded the place is. But I totally forgot about that. So yeah, today was quite scary.
Scary and weird.
Yeah.
You know, the other thing that I was thinking about just now was, you know how queues will form outside the stores, you know, waiting for themselves to go in, right? To be admitted. But I was also thinking that how long can people queue? If people really, really want to go Daiso, for example, and there's a crowd, if people kept queuing, do you remember that news at America? The one that they wanted to go to supermarket?
Oh yeah, all the way to like, don't know where, right?
The queue was about 5 kilometers long. That was just crazy. So I was just thinking that maybe the store, what they could do is to also limit people from queuing.
Oh, that's true.
So they could do like, okay, we only limit 5 people in the queue. Any person after the 5th person, please go somewhere else and come back later. I don't know.
I think that was what Stereo at Plaza Singapura did.
Oh, they did?
I didn't
catch
past
what she was saying.
We were walking past and then the queue was quite long. We saw the gaming shop, Game Mats, and then after that it was their line, right? Times, and then it's their line.
Yeah.
So one of the staff was just like, until a particular person, she was like, okay, if you're going to wait here, it's going to take like 25 to 30 minutes for you to wait to get in. So I would recommend that you go somewhere else first and then come back 20-25 minutes later. But like, some of them were compliant, but there was this lady who just like, but it's not fair.
Oh, she was scalping.
Yeah, she was like,
right?
But it's not fair. What if you walk away and then someone else will come in?
Yeah.
And it's not fair. Like, I was just like, sis, you know, life is short. Like, don't spend your time queuing. But then again, Singaporeans love to queue. And I queue in to get into a shop. So I'm like, again, pot calling the kettle black.
And then the other thing, what they could probably do is, you know how telcos, they issue numbers, numbers, or polyclinics, right?
Don't say polyclinic, bubble tea.
Bubble tea. Or, okay, numbers is one. And, you know, sometimes you have to input your number, your contact number.
Oh, yeah, so that they will message you, right?
Yeah, I think that's a very good idea. Yeah. So people can just go somewhere else and when it's their time to come in, then you can just re-queue.
Yeah,
re-queue.
Another store that we saw with like an incredibly long line was Apple.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, that was the queue barricade that was created. Literally looked like when they were going to launch iPhone 11.
Yeah, we actually wanted to go to Apple to get something.
Yeah.
All right, but we totally passed because it's crazy. The queue was, like what you say, it's like queuing for a new launch, a new product launch.
Barricade, I mean, like, it's not a bad thing in a way whereby like, I think we did, it didn't matter to us because whatever that we wanted to buy was really it's important, yeah. But it's not like it's I not need it immediately, need. You know.
Not critical.
Yeah, and like from what we saw, it was no, and you have to queue outside. There were like Apple peeps outside to help. I mean, like to answer your questions or whatever. Yeah. But yeah. Whatever it is, you still have to like go and see inside, ma.
Yeah. No. Okay. That's one. The second thing I'm overly impressed with people queuing outside of Apple is that the outside queue is not. It's an outdoor setting.
Yeah, it's so hot.
And today is very humid and warm.
Yeah.
And I don't know how they can tahan. I don't know. I, you know, just walking from point to point, I'm already sweating. I don't know what more you just, you know, queue in the hot sun and just waiting for your turn to come in. I'm quite sure whoever's inside the Apple store sure got sweat smell, and it's a collective sweat smell.
But with that being said, I guess like hats off to like Apple for being really, they're very serious about it, because the Apple guys, if y'all been to like the Apple store around like Somerset, right, it is like double story freaking huge one, and yet like when we looked in, do you realize that there's actually not many people inside?
Yeah, they were
like every
limiting
row,
people. Yeah, yeah.
Because it's so big, right? Then you know how Apple has like rows and rows of tables with their products, right? They have two sets of those rows, but only like one set below. I don't know. I think I can count with my fingers the amount of customers that were inside, and I haven't even seen what is upstairs. So I think they were taking their quota very seriously. Yeah,
they have to.
Which is not wrong, yeah. But that's how the queues form. Right, and
right. I think as much as possible, any businesses don't want to be the new cluster.
Right? For sure.
Yeah, that will affect their branding. It will affect everything. And who knows, they might have to close down to be disinfected before they can open up again. So there's a lot of factors for these businesses to think about. It is always great to see these shops opening up again, right, during phase two. And of course, being ready to operate again, you have businesses resuming again. And that means people are earning and people are getting paid.
Yeah, right? that's the one thing that I was thinking also.
Yeah, which is a good, but at the same time, there's a lot of risk also. So yeah, it's really a very, very precarious position to be in.
It's like you're literally living life on the edge.
Yeah, really. You're just really now, I was like,
"Han, I think we should go. Yeah. I don't think we should stay here."
You know, when we were going outside of Ion, right?
Yeah.
I was like, you know, to me, it was like crossing a heavy expressway, a congested expressway. I was just looking left and right. Okay. Who to avoid? Okay. Got window of opportunity. Okay, go, zoom, yeah. Go, walk.
So, like, we need to go up. We need to go walk upstairs. Like, we can't walk through Wisma, because not only do you have to check in into Wisma from again. Like,
oh yeah. So these days, everywhere is check in, check out.
But I really feel that our check in, check out system is very crucial during this period. I think that's why Seoul unfortunately had or is having more clusters forming up, because I don't know personally, I do not know how their system is like over there, but because for us like we know every 2 weeks they refresh that list, right, of people who infected, people go visit where, and all of that actually plays a big role to safeguard everyone else. So honestly, I was telling Karun this afternoon, like, I'm actually fine. It's a little bit troublesome, but I'm actually fine with this safe entry thing. It's like, you know how we tap in and out of an EasyLink of a bus or an MRT station? It's kind of like that, but but it's just like everywhere you go in, like every establishment that you go in. So I think it's just for our safety, and I think it's a good thing for us to do. It may be something that other countries don't adopt, which is why they have trouble containing
and tracking.
Yeah, and tracking. Mm. Yeah, and tracking all of this, like contact tracing, basically.
Yeah. Luckily, in Singapore, we don't have anti-mask people.
Oh, good Lord.
Oh my God, this morning we were watching seriously ridiculous people coming to the, I believe it was the
like
Senate.
A, like, like a not court lah. I don't know why is it. I mean, it's based in America lah.
Yeah, it was a Senate hearing probably. And these groups of people, they were just one at a time pleading their case as to why they don't need mask.
No mask. Yeah. God as, made us brief.
And you know why I don't wear mask? Same thing as why I don't wear underwear.
It needs to breathe.
I'm like, what? Woman, what the hell are you talking about? And all of these people, not all, majority of them, they were bringing God into the equation, explaining to the Senate that why there is no need for a mask is because, look, God made us such way, you
breathe know, life breathe, into
breathe
us.
Breathe life into us. And if God wants us to wear a mask, God would have put a mask on our faces. Then I'm like, girl, why are you wearing clothes? You were born out of your mom. Naked. Okay, there wasn't any tank top and mini skirt and long pants.
You were not fully clothed.
Yeah, you were not. Exactly. And suddenly they brought God into the picture and they were not making any sense in their argument. I don't know how these people...
I loved majority of that video. I was like, what?
And they were so angry.
No, they were so passionate about it. You know, like, oh my God, yes, anti-mask.
They believe that they are right. I don't know how.
These people are so weird. I'm so sorry, but... I shouldn't be so judgy, but...
Okay, I want to be judgy here.
Okay.
I, for some reason, I'm also thinking that the people who are anti-mask have the same belief system as flat earth. Okay, that's a whole entire new topic. It's an entire topic. We'll probably revisit that in a future episode. It's a very fun thing to talk about. Flat earthers. Yeah. I don't know how the thought process of these people are. They can talk like that. They are super passionate about what they feel and what they think. And above all, they feel that they are right.
Yeah.
Yeah, that one I cannot. That one
these
I
are the
give
same
up.
People who like, I'm sure you've watched those videos on Facebook where like, you know, if you people want to go to, especially in America, they want to go to like supermarket or something and then they refuse to wear a mask.
Yeah, they were adamant.
And then like there's mask stuff like go and like block the person from coming. It's so funny. And then
I have rights. Look, it's my constitutional rights that I don't need to wear a mask. Blah, blah, blah. You can't stop me, bitch.
Fool. This is a free country.
Right? I can do whatever I want.
Read the constitution. This is the land of the free.
I don't need a mask. I don't need someone tell me if I can wear a mask or not. Like, girl, this is how the world is right now.
It's like, sekarang kau lah nak, kau nak buat apa? Like, up to you, okay? Seriously, up to you.
Susah lah.
And interestingly enough, like all these, majority of them, I think I read an article, they say that like majority of these anti-maskers are like from Florida.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, they just...
I wonder why.
I don't know. I thought they were they're considered a sunshine state, right? I thought they're more like a lot of young people. I don't know. I'm not sure. I've never been to America and I don't think I can and I will because I'm afraid.
These people could be hippie as well. You know, the hippie lifestyle, the hippie culture, I don't know. I'm just assuming. I could be wrong.
I don't know. I mean, we don't know the US enough to say much. So
what we know is that we wouldn't want to live there.
I don't think it's a place for us lah.
No, not for anyone, I think. Yeah.
I mean, some people will find it like something that they like.
The current leadership is in power, I don't think anyone should live there.
Never mind. I'll just stay where I am.
Yeah.
You know, there's a peribahasa like...
What peribahasa?
Hujan emas di...
Whoa.
What? Hujan emas di... Di negeri orang or something like that.
Hujan emas di negeri orang.
Wait.
Hujan lebat di Singapura. Hujan lebat hingga flash flood. Hari-hari tak boleh pergi kerja. Wow!
Okay. So guys, the correct peribahasa is daripada hujan emas di negeri orang, lebih baik hujan batu di negeri sendiri. So it means no matter how easy it looks or how advanced a particular country seems to you, it's easier or it's more comfortable for you to live in wherever you from, like live at wherever you are. So it's like, you know, those kind of like the grass is greener on the other side. But if you water the grass here, you also can be green, something like that.
Gee, philosophical.
Sorry, it just got into my head lah.
Wow, okay, wow.
Malay A1 tapi sekarang dah macam what?
Hey, at least you got A1. I got C6 on 2 tries.
Oh my god.
Okay, for first O-level exam, C6. Second O-level exam, I thought I could do better. C6.
At least I had a second chance.
Yeah, that's right. Okay, we're going to take a break right now and giving you the next advertisement.
Everything at Adina Anis is made by her own operations to ensure the best quality possible. To get your Lux Turban, Lux Square, Echo Soul and Tri Scarves, visit www.adinaanis.com, Singapore's modest premier fashion designer.
Okay, that was our second advertisement. Now, we are going to give you guys tips on how to survive even better during phase two. How about that?
Yeah, sounds good. Useful.
Okay, tip number one. Tiara has actually got a list. I cannot think of any.
Yeah, I have a list.
Tiara, first one.
All right. If you have the ability to head out on a weekday, head out on a weekday.
Yeah, don't wait for the weekend where everyone's not working and head down at the same time. That's where crowds happen.
Correct. Avoid meal times.
Wait, avoid meal times?
Yeah.
Avoid peak period.
Yeah, peak meal times.
Okay, peak period and meal times.
So avoid peak period. Peak period usually is like lunchtime, dinner time. These two timings is where people will always flock to certain areas to eat fine food. So like stay away from that timing. I think the sweet spot that we've realized since last week was to reach a particular location at around 11 or 11:30 and then bounce off before like 12:30 or 1 o'clock. And you can actually, after you're done, wherever you're at, like around 12:30, 1 o'clock, where people are actually going into malls to eat, go to a cafe for coffee. Because while people are eating, you're just like chilling, having coffee. And then if you are intending to have lunch outside, I guess you will have to have slightly later lunches because you want to miss all of the lunch crowds. Another tip we have is use the spaceout.gov website where you can actually like see which malls are like a lot of people, which are empty, which is packed, so you can kind of
stagger your time.
Yeah, correct. Other than that, go to like malls that are not really busy.
Not those prime malls.
Yeah, so like Ion Orchard, like avoid, like if you want to go Ion Orchard, can. But again, I recommend go like around 10:30 or 11 o'clock so that you miss the crowd. Because crowds will only come or usually come like late in like noontime because everyone wants to go and eat. Another one is to just have your phone handy so that you can easily scan the QR code. Or if you don't want to scan the QR code,
I want to say something about this. I would really, really plead to everyone to just use your phone and scan the QR code rather than taking your ICE and then scan it. What I've observed is that people who use their ICs, sometimes the machine cannot really scan your ICs properly, and that's where the holdup happens.
Yeah,
so once you have that, imagine if there are 10 people who use their ICs in the very beginning. Yeah, and it's going to be a snowball effect, and everyone will get held up, and from there a crowd is going to be formed. And that's what you don't want. For all you know, the cluster could be right at the entrance of the shopping mall.
Yeah, oddly.
Yeah, that's the worst thing.
The only people I say that will be allowed to use to scan their IC is like older people. Because I think QR code is something like that doesn't... My dad is not really a tech-savvy person. So he gets very overwhelmed and he like, I don't know how to use this. So I would understand, like if I ask my grandma to like, scan QR code. Phone pun tak ada nak scan QR code apa. So only like those are the people who I think have the like fast pass lah, or rather the I close one eye to scan using IC. But if let's say you are someone who's tech savvy, you have a phone, you know how QR codes work, don't be lazy and just scan the dang QR code.
Yep. Or if you own a smartphone, okay, as long as you own a smartphone, you got no excuse.
Yeah.
IC, it will be secondary. Primarily, it should be your iPhone. No, not your iPhone. Your smartphone and your QR code. Okay, this will save a lot of time. It will create less problem. Don't be part of the problem.
Yeah, and also another thing or another tip that I have actually is to download the SingPass app on your phone.
Yeah, I have not done that. How does that work?
So SingPass app, all you have to do is it's the app for your SingPass. So you just sign in with your SingPass ID and your password, and basically it's within the SingPass app, there's the safe entry, check in and check out system on the home, but on the home screen. So whenever you want to go to a place, you can just hit the check in button, and they will actually, there are two ways they can actually detect like whatever that's closest to you, and if you find it, you can edit, click that and just hit check in. Or if you can't find it in the list, you can type it out. And if you really can't find it, just go back to the SingPass home, like the home page on the app, and they actually have this like button where you can actually scan a QR code, and you can just scan as per usual, like how you would if you are just using the QR code reader on your phone, for example. So what that does is that, right, it's literally like you're just tapping your phone to get into places, but instead of like tapping like an EZ-Link card, you're just tapping the checking in button. So it saves the hassle of like opening your camera, scanning the thing, or if those of you who don't have, like for example, if I use the QR code on my phone, I have to use the camera button, I mean the camera function. So I have to scan it and then I have to hit, then it has to open to Chrome. And then when it's at Chrome, then I have to like check in. And then when I want to check out, I have to scan again. Or I have to go to Chrome and like, so many tabs.
So there's a few more steps if you don't use the app.
Yeah, so the SingPass app is just you open it, then straight away you can save entry, check in. And then you can just check in. If you can't find the location, you can just scan it. So instead of going to, I mean, for me, I personally use the SingPass app because it's much faster for me. So that's just my personal preference. And when you do scan your SingPass app and then you are checked in, don't be difficult. Just make sure that you already show that you have checked into the staff there, because they are also trying to like help people get in quicker, so that there's no hold up. So just be mindful lah. Don't be like at the counter there, then you're like I haven't scanned the QR code, can y'all please just not do that? Like,
yeah, I think
don't,
it's very,
do it.
Very important for people to have this mindset that the people who are taking your temperature and looking at your check-in check-out, those guys, those ladies or those gentlemen, they're not there to prevent you. They're not there to make things difficult for you. They are supposed to help you facilitate. Okay, they are employed so that they can help to mitigate, you know, this pandemic together. So guys, if you are always thinking that these people are trying to make your life difficult, you have a very, very, very negative mindset. Okay, you need to change. You have to look at the bigger picture. Don't just think about yourself. Think about the bigger picture. And that's very, very important.
Yeah. So I think all in all, those are the tips that we have. Another one is, I guess, of course, this one should come as no surprise, but hand sanitizer. So like whenever you, before, if you are going to eat outside, make sure that you sanitize before you eat, sanitize after, go to the washroom and wash your hands. Whenever you touch like a surface, so what I always do is after I step out from a store, I'll also sanitize my hands. And all of the stores now, even if you don't bring your own, all of the stores actually have their own hand sanitizers and they just let you use them. So use that to your advantage. Mm. I mean, it's better to be safe.
Yeah, and hand sanitizers these days, they are not on short demand anymore.
Yeah, you can find them like literally everywhere.
Yeah, I mean, they're actually short demand. Short supply.
Short supply.
Yeah, the demand is always there. And right now, you don't see any cases where they are out of stock for
hand sanitizers. Yeah, masks also.
Yeah, masks also. You can see probably every pharmacy out there, like Watson's, NTUC, Cold Storage, what's the other one? Guardian. They all have plentiful supply of hand sanitizers. This one is a bonus tip. If you don't want to carry those, or if you don't want to buy those small, small, expensive hand sanitizers, yeah, don't do that. Get a big one, like a 2-liter hand sanitizer bottle. Buy that for the entire family. Buy those small, small bottles from Daiso, and then just pump in whatever that you require. And from there, you can save a little bit of money.
I actually, personally, I always bring an extra mask. Because I prefer to use the surgical mask, the one-time use one. I mean, I've ordered some that's reusable, but currently I'm using the surgical mask. So I would recommend to bring an extra one in your bag just in case the current one that you're wearing gets soiled, you dropped it on the floor, it hit some random surface. Just have something, just put it inside like a Ziploc bag or something, so that just in case if anything happens, you have a backup mask, because you do not want to be caught without one. If not, you're going to be fined. So let's all not do that. Just be mindful. Like, just stay away from people. Karun and I always like, oh my god, don't stand so close to people. Like, go away.
Okay, so those are some of the tips. Now we're just going to wrap it up because we are at the 1 hour mark. Okay, I just want to say that for phase two, what phase two means for me is I'm still not very used to walking for a long duration with my mask on. That will take some time getting used to, especially in our climate, in our weather, where, and for me, especially when I walk from point A to B, chances are I will sweat. And with the mask on, I will sweat times three. Breathing is a little bit more difficult. So if anyone out there who has some breathing conditions, okay, it is not advisable to walk for a long duration and have the mask on. So if you do need that, the best possible thing to do is to stop maybe at certain points, have a break, get a coffee or something. Because when you drink, you don't have to put your mask on. You can take off your mask, breathe some fresh air fresh-ish air, smell the coffee and everything. Once you're okay, once your breathing goes back to normal, there you can proceed to your destination. So yeah, for me, there's still some time getting used to. What I haven't tried is walking the entire day with my mask on. I haven't tried that. But for the last two weekends, short spurts, right? Short spurts would be, it's quite difficult. I was facing challenge, to walk from point A to point B with the mask on.
Today wasn't so bad. Or if you are intending to walk with your mask on for long periods of time, like do it indoors, I think today was a little bit better because we were not outside that much. The only time we were outside was when we walked from Chinatown MRT to Keong Side Road.
That wasn't so bad because the weather was still okay.
It was early in the morning.
Yeah, I think it was during noon, afternoon. That was the bad time.
Quite tough.
Yeah, so guys, that's anything about you? You want to?
Not really. For phase two, I'm still walking. I do agree with you. The walking is quite challenging with a mask on. Another thing is I'm just still paranoid. Like, I'm still not used to it. Like, I'm really grateful that we are given the opportunity to kind of feel a little bit normal. But at the same time, this morning I told him I was very scared. I was like, oh my god, I'm very paranoid. Because it was just, I'm still afraid. If this is going to be the new normal, then I really feel like all of us need to play a big part to ensure that we are responsible enough to continue practicing good hygiene, wear your mask, and
if you are sick, do not go out and mix around. Go to the clinic or the hospital and get yourself checked instead.
And like, I don't know. I think I am not comfortable meeting other people yet. Mm. Guys, I only like when I go out the last 2 weekends, I only go out with Karun only. Like,
not because you are sombong, eh?
No. I miss my friends and we all like want to meet up, but I think all of us are just
a bit scared.
A bit scared. Mm. Because once we gather and then like we don't know what we're gonna bring home to our families, it's just like maybe not yet. I think when things are more stable, inshallah, if that's what I hope. Well, yeah, I'm just not ready for a meal with 4 other people.
Mm,
you know, other than family, like, I mean, family is fine, but other than that, I'm still a bit, I'm a bit scared. Like, at least if it's in at home, like, it's a little bit contained. But if you're outside, it's like you and your 4 friends and everyone else. It's kind of daunting and it's normal. So if for those of you who are still afraid, it's fine. And another thing is both of us, we only go out like within the week, maybe like 1 or 2 days. Why I say 2 days is because tomorrow I want to go. Can I go and read a book at a cafe?
Tomorrow? We'll see about it.
Anyway, not important. But yeah, Karen and I usually just go out like once a week. Other than that, we don't go out.
Yeah, Monday to Fridays, we're just stuck at home and doing our work.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's life. All right, I hope this episode has been quite insightful. Have been giving some information to you guys. Hope you enjoy these topics of the week thingy. And the shout-outs, if you really want us to do some advertisement kind of shout-outs, okay, do like what we said just now in the earlier portion of this episode, just email to us and we can do the necessary.
Yeah.
Okay, guys. That's it from us. We'll see you in the next episode.
Bye.
Bye.